Today I'm going to talk about the most competitive medical residencies, specifically which specialties are the most challenging to get into. If you're currently in medical school, you've probably given some thought to which specialty you'd like to pursue and why. Lots of different factors go into this decision, like salary, work-life balance, and of course, your interests. Another factor that sometimes gets overlooked, the competition to enter certain specialties, which can vary significantly. I'm Dr. Eve Bishop, residency admissions expert from Shemasi and Academic Consulting. In this video, I'll go over which residencies are the most competitive to match with and why. I'll answer questions like, what are the fill rates for competitive residencies? What step scores do you need to match with them? And what are average salaries for these specialties? This will give you the information you need to help decide which specialty is right for you. Let's get started. Matching with a residency position is an accomplishment, no matter which specialty you're going into. During the 2020 NRMP main residency match, 40,084 applicants competed for 37,256 spots, which shows us that across all specialties, there were more people looking to match than positions available. Let's dig a little deeper into that statistic. Those 40,000 or so applicants include seniors in both MD and DO programs, as we'd expect, plus international medical students and American med school grads who didn't match in previous years. It's also worth pointing out that the approximately 37,000 residency spots I mentioned include both postgraduate year 1 or PGY1 and postgraduate year 2 or PGY2 positions. Let's go over what you can expect if you're a U.S. med school student looking to match into PGY1 positions. In 2020, among U.S. medical school seniors, 93.7% of MD students and 90.7% of DO students matched with a PGY1 position. Pretty good, right? While those statistics are somewhat reassuring, they don't tell the whole story. When we take a closer look, we can see that slightly over a third of those PGY1 positions filled by MD seniors and just over half of those filled by DO seniors were in the primary care specialties: family medicine, internal medicine, and pediatrics. Not all specialties are equal in how accessible or challenging it is to match with them. A high percentage of matches overall don't really indicate the varying competitiveness of each individual specialty. For a more nuanced match rate, we look to fill rates. Why is it significant that so many medical school seniors match into primary care residencies? The answer has to do with fill rates. First, let's define that term. The fill rate of a residency specialty is the percentage of available positions that are filled by U.S. medical school seniors. It's an important metric because the NRMP considers the most competitive residency specialties those that have the highest fill rates. So, what are the fill rates in primary care? Pediatrics has a fill rate of 60.4%, internal medicine's fill rate is 40.2%, and family medicine has a fill rate of 33.1%. To be clear, we're discussing the competitiveness of entire specialties rather than individual residency programs. However, individual programs within less competitive specialties can have a wide range of selectivity. For example, even though pediatrics is a less competitive specialty overall, certain programs like Boston Children's are still highly selective, whereas others like Rutgers New Jersey Medical School are considered more accessible. On the other hand, matching with nearly any individual residency program in the most competitive specialties will be a challenge. To come up with a list of competitive specialties, we considered those that offered at least 30 positions in 2020. We based our selections on fill rates and data taken from the last few years of the NRMP main residency match, like the number of positions available per applicant and mean step scores for matched and unmatched applicants. We consider orthopedic surgery residencies to be the most competitive to match into. Orthopedic surgery has the highest fill rate of any specialty at 94%. And in 2018, it had only 0.81 positions available for every U.S. med school senior who applied. This is an important stat because it shows that more seniors applied than there were positions available. Furthermore, applicants who match into orthopedic surgery had excellent average step scores of 248 for step one and 255 for step two. Next, we have otolaryngology. Otolaryngology is similarly competitive to orthopedic surgery with a fill rate of 93.5%, 0.77 positions per M4 applicant, and nearly identical average step scores for successful applicants. Plastic surgery has a slightly lower fill rate of 91.7%, but in contrast had 0.72 available positions per M4 applicant, which is even fewer than orthopedic surgery or otolaryngology. Step scores needed to match into plastic surgery are similarly high as what we've already seen. Next, let's talk about neurological surgery. Neurosurgery is nearly identical to the specialties we've already gone over in terms of available positions and average step scores. However, its fill rate is a little lower at 88.8%. Like neurosurgery, vascular surgery has a similar fill rate of 88% and a similar number of positions for each med school senior who applied, 0.81. However, its average step scores for matched applicants are quite a bit lower than what we've seen so far, 236 for step one and 244 for step two. While we still consider vascular surgery residencies to be challenging to match into, out of the 8 highly competitive residency specialties we're talking about today, vascular surgery is the only one in which average step scores are actually fairly close to average scores across all specialties. The fill rate for thoracic surgery is a few percentage points lower at 86.8%. Its number of available positions is much lower than what we've seen so far, only 0.44 positions per med school senior who applied. While we don't have official NRMP data on average step scores for thoracic surgery, based on anecdotal evidence, we can say that med school seniors who successfully match into thoracic surgery typically have similar scores to successful applicants in other integrated surgical residencies like neurological, orthopedic, or plastic surgery. That would put average step scores for thoracic surgery at approximately 240 to 250 for step one and 250 to 255 for step two. Interventional radiology has similar stats to thoracic surgery, a fill rate of 85.8% and a low 0.42 available positions per M4 applicant. Average matched applicants had step scores of 246 for step one and 255 for step two. Finally, we have dermatology. While dermatology has the lowest fill rate of any specialty on the list, 84.8%, it still only has 0.67 positions per senior applicant, and the average step scores needed to match in dermatology are actually some of the highest scores across all specialties. Dermatology is also something of an outlier among the most competitive specialties. Because it only requires 4 years of residency training, the least of any specialty on this list. Nevertheless, dermatology is still a highly competitive specialty for reasons we'll discuss momentarily. What can we take away from this data? First, let's turn to fill rates. As we've just seen, the most selective residency specialties generally have a fill rate of 85% or higher. To put that figure in perspective, consider that the average fill rate across all specialties in 2020 was 70.2%. And as we talked about earlier, primary care fill rates were even lower, with family medicine being the lowest at 33.1%. So, matching with positions in the 8 specialties we just discussed is significantly more competitive than average. Why are these residencies so competitive? One reason has to do with future pay. It probably goes without saying that doctors are well paid, regardless of specialty. After all, in 2020, the average physician salary is $243,000 for PCPs and $346,000 for specialists. However, as we saw earlier, average salaries for some specialties are much higher. In particular, the highest pay grades go to the surgical specialties like neurological, thoracic, and orthopedic surgeries, which command over $500,000 a year on average. Clearly, residency specialties that are the most challenging to match into correspond with some of the best paid specialties in medicine. Money isn't the only factor, though. While a specialty like dermatology usually pays less than the surgical specialties, though still well above average, it's still competitive to match with because of its enviable work-life balance. Not only are dermatologists well compensated, they also tend to have flexible schedules and comparatively reasonable workloads, which understandably appeal to many medical students. Plus, as I mentioned earlier, dermatology only requires 4 years of residency training, whereas other highly competitive specialties take anywhere from 5 to 8 years of specialized training before you're eligible for certification. Another reason why certain specialties are competitive to match into has to do with the sheer number of positions available in that specialty. For example, in 2020, though only 92 medical school seniors in the US applied to vascular surgery residencies, they were competing for just 75 spots. As I mentioned earlier, this works out to only 0.81 available positions for every M4 applicant. To contrast this, let's take a look at internal medicine. While internal medicine received far more applicants from US med school seniors, around 6,000, it also offered over 9,000 positions. This means that there were 1.5 positions available for each M4 applicant, making internal medicine residencies significantly easier to match into than residencies in vascular surgery. Generally speaking, the most competitive residency specialties offer fewer than one positions per med school senior who applies to that specialty. To be in the running for the most competitive residencies, you'll need exceptional USMLE STEP scores. To illustrate this point, let's consider that in 2018, the average scores among US medical school seniors who matched into any residency were 233 for STEP 1 and 246 for STEP 2. On the other hand, the average scores for 2020 applicants who matched into the highly competitive specialties we discussed earlier, with the exception of vascular surgery, were around 246 for STEP 1 and 255 for STEP 2, a significant jump up. Applicants who failed to match in those same competitive specialties scored, on average, 239 for STEP 1 and 245 for STEP 2, which are similar or even higher than the average scores of matched applicants across all specialties. So, we can say that the majority of highly competitive residencies will require test scores that are far above average. While matching is something to be proud of regardless of which specialty you go into, applicants to certain residencies will face significantly stiffer competition than applicants to others. To determine which residencies you should apply to, consider what's important to you in terms of factors like pay, work-life balance, how many years you're willing to train for, and your interests. Then compare your test scores to different specialties' averages to make a data-driven choice that will give you the very best chance of matching right out of med school. And that's it. If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up and feel free to leave a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. And if you'd like to learn more about how to maximize your chances of matching into your top choice program, check out the description box below for some helpful resources. Thanks again for watching. See you next time.